गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू इंग्लिश टू क्लास. एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीटेड द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ ऑल द चैप्टर्स दैट आर कमिंग इन योर मिड टर्म एग्जाम. सो नाउ आई विल जस्ट डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स एंड आई विल टेल यू द आंसर्स ऑफ ईच क्वेश्चन. यू विल राइट डाउन. ओके, नाउ नंबर बी ए द आंसर इज, आई एम टेलिंग यू द आंसर्स ओनली, यू विल राइट मैच द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर बुक. ओके, वन ए, this land was in the village of Kunu. This land was situated in a narrow grassy valley crisscrossed by clear streams and overlooked by green hills. Okay, this is 1b, 1a. Number b, the kind of houses that were there on this land were huts that were beehive shaped structures of mud walls with a wooden pole in the center holding up a peaked grass roof. The floor was made of crust and hip, which was kept smooth by smearing it regularly with fresh cow dung. Now number C, this is B number C. Okay, the residents of this land were deprived of private land, private title to land. They were tenants paying rent annually to the government. Next, two, number A, the boys were taking turns climbing up and down the donkey's back. Okay, now two, B, the unruly donkey taught the writer a lesson by, you will write bolting. Okay, this is wrong. It bolted. You will cut this. You will write bolting. B O L T I N G. Bolting into a nearby thorn bush, it bent its head, trying to unseat the writer, which it did, but not before the thorns had pricked and scratched his face, embarrassing him in front of his friends. Now number C, after this experience, the writer felt embarrassed in front of his friends. He felt as if he had lost his face among his friends. Now I will discuss D number 1. The hut floor was kept smooth by smearing it regularly with fresh cow dung. Number 2, the skills that Mandela learnt in his childhood are: he learned how to knock birds out of the sky with a slingshot, to gather wild honey and fruits and edible roots, to drink warm sweet milk straight from the udder, U-double-D-E-R, udder, okay, udder of a cow, to swim in the clear cold streams and to catch fish with twine and sharpened bits of wire. And he learned to stick by. Next is number 3. What kind of toys that the kind of toys that the children played with in Kunu were made by themselves? They molded animals and birds out of clay. They made ox-drawn sledges out of the tree branches. Nature was their playground. Okay, number 4. Mandela enjoyed himself as a herd boy, as if it was in the fields that he had learnt how to knock birds. And the rest of the answer you will write down from answer number 2, whatever I said, how to knock birds. As I said in answer number 2, from here, how to knock birds, and the total whatever is written here, out of the sky with a slingshot to gather honey, wild honey and the fruits and edible roots, to drink warm sweet milk straight from the udder of a cow, to swim in the clear cold streams and to catch fish with twine and sharpened bits of wire, and he learned to stick fight. Up to here is your answer for answer number 4 also. Same answer. Those huts, 5 number, those huts were used for one for cooking, one for sleeping and one for storage. Number 6, the narrator said this because most of the men spent the greater part of the year working on remote farms or in the mines along the reef, they returned perhaps twice a year mainly to pluck their fields. Okay, now E number one. The life of the African woman in Kunu is difficult one because the water used for farming, cooking and washing had to be fetched in buckets by the women from the streams and springs. The hoeing, weeding and harvesting are left to the women. The men only plugged the fields. Plugged, P-L-O-U-G-H-T, plugged the fields. Okay, this is E number one. E number 2 we have already discussed in our class. Okay, now we will do the next chapter's question answers. Chapter number 10, in time of drought. Only answers I am giving children because time is not there. So, see only the answers. These four lines describe the situation of drought as in the time of drought where the fields are furrowed, the seed is sown, there is not a drop of rain. The poet asked God that how would they get the grain for the harvest and how they feed the poor if there is no rain. This is A1A. Okay, now B number. Furrowed fields means plucking furrows in the field. Okay, B number 1. The poet has described the drought hit landscape by the phrases like pangs of drought, no dews from the heavens, waterless gullies. Okay, now number 2. Sheep and cattle look with wistful eyes because the water of the rivers have dried due to no rainfall in the time of drought. Okay, next number 3. The poet meant by no dews from the heavens that there is no rainfall. Number 4. The tropic seas that are being referred to in the poem are the oceans, or it refers to the depth of the sea to the height of the clouds. Number 5. Achilles, who was the personification of Achilles River, one of the longest rivers of Greece. C. Number 1. The poet addresses the snow on Himalaya's head as soft snows because the soft snow on the peak of the Himalayan mountain melt and fall on the form of water. Next 2. The poet says that our needs was great because our needs was a lot more than God can give us. Okay. These are the question answers of chapter number 10. Now I will give you the question answers of chapter number 11. Dostoevsky writes from prison. Okay. B. Answer with reference to the context. Number A. What strange thing happened? The strange thing that happened was a few minutes before they were to be executed, their punishment was changed. Number B. Changing of punishment from execution to sending them to Siberia was strange about this happening. Next 2. Number A. The writer would start the journey to Siberia the next day. B. The writer made the request to his brother to send him some money to buy stationery and to write long letters to him. C. He made such requests because his brother's letter will give him hope and life. Number 3A. These lines convey about Dostoevsky's state of mind that he did not lose hope and he decided to live life with joy in his heart rather than regretting about the precious time he has wasted. B. He talked about mistakes he had made. It will be made, okay, and that he had wasted a lot of precious time in dreams. He did not know how to use time and how to live. This one you will write made, M-A-D-E, okay. Now C number. The lesson that we get from these two lines are we should not waste time in dreams, rather than we should know how to use time and we should not lose hope and live life joyfully. Okay. Now see number 1. Dostoevsky and his friends were punished because they joined a socialist group that intended to bring about political reforms in Russia. Number 2. The change in the punishment given to Dostoevsky and his friends was it was decided to send them to Siberia. Number 3. Dostoevsky refused to be unhappy. नंबर फोर, अकॉर्डिंग टू डॉस्टोयेवस्की लाइफ इज एवरीवेयर, लाइफ इज इन आवर सेल्व्स, इट इज नॉट आउटसाइड अस. नाउ डी नंबर वन, डॉस्टोयेवस्की मेंट बाय ब्रेकिंग वन सेल्फ इनटू टू दैट गोइंग अवे फ्रॉम एवरीथिंग दैट इज डियर टू हिम एंड लिविंग इन साइबेरिया, दैट इज हिज हार्ट विल लिव विथ हिज डियर वंस एंड हिज बॉडी विल लिव इन साइबेरिया. ओके, सो दिस इज डी नंबर वन आंसर. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, व्हाई डज डॉस्टोयेवस्की आस्क हिज ब्रदर टू राइट लॉन्ग लेटर्स. यू विल राइट द आंसर एज डॉस्टोयेवस्की आस्क हिज ब्रदर टू राइट लॉन्ग लेटर्स बिकॉज हिज ब्रदर्स लेटर्स विल गिव हिम होप एंड लाइफ. सो चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल द चैप्टर्स एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑल्सो. यू विल लर्न एंड राइट देम फर्स्ट एंड देन यू विल लर्न देम. ओके, सो ड्यू टू नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम क्वेश्चन आंसर्स वेर नॉट बींग अपलोडेड, टाइम वॉज शॉर्ट, सो आई हैव डन इन वन वीडियो ऑल द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. सो चिल्ड्रन, यू विल राइट देम एंड लर्न देम. ओके, टिल देन टेक केयर, बाय एंड थैंक यू चिल्ड्रन.